Next example, evaluate integration of sine pi z square plus cos pi z square upon z minus 1 whole square into z minus 2. And here they have given three options. First circle they have given of radius 3. Second circle they have given of radius 1 by 2. Third circle they have given of radius 3 by 2. So we have to check this integral for all three and we have to conclude the result. So one of the again important question for examination, I can say. So given integration of sine pi z square plus cos pi z square upon z minus 1 whole square into z minus 2. So you consider f of z as same previous what we have taken. So sine pi z square plus cos pi z square, and we shall first solve what here 1 upon z minus 1 square into z minus 2. So on simplification by using partial fraction, so we'll get the value of b as minus 1, c as 1 and a as minus 1. Apply these values here and we'll get this result: minus 1 upon z minus 1 plus minus 1 upon z minus 1 whole square plus 1 upon z minus 2. So for this you multiply sine pi z square plus cos pi z square and take integration on both sides. We get, so left hand side integration sine pi z square plus cos pi z square upon z minus 1 square into z minus 2 dz. So minus will come outside because here what we have here, so this minus sign and this minus sign both will come outside. This minus, plus into minus is minus, and this minus will come out, and we take integration on both sides. So minus times integration of sine pi z square plus cos pi z square upon z minus 1 into dz minus minus integration of sine pi z square plus cos pi z square upon z minus 1 whole square, this is second integral, plus integration of sine pi z square plus cos pi z square into dz upon z minus 2, third integral. So what shall we do here? So what left hand side we have will give I first integral, which is nothing but minus times I will give as I1 and minus times I2 plus I3, give equation 1, because we have, they have given three conditions. So we have to check these I1, I2, I3 for all three and we have to conclude the result. Just see here how to simplify such problem. So first I have taken first circle, they have given mod z is equal to 3. So mod z is equal to 3, we have to check for I1, I2, I3. So I1, in I1 the value of a is 1. In integration I1, I1 stand for first integration. In this value of a is what here? 1. In second integral I2, value of a is again 1. In third integral value of a is 2. So 1, 1, 2. This all 1, 1, 2 will come inside the circle of radius 3. So therefore we can say that, so for the first integral I1, for this integral we will apply Cauchy's integral formula. And for the third integral we'll apply Cauchy's integral formula, but for second integral, because it is z minus 1 whole square, because of this square we need to apply Cauchy general generalized Cauchy's integral formula. So therefore z is equal to 1 and this is z is equal to 1 and for z is equal to 2 lies inside mod z is equal to 3. So for I1 and I3 we'll apply Cauchy's integral formula, and for I2 will apply generalized Cauchy's integral formula. So therefore, so first we'll simplify for I1. So 2 pi I of f of a, right hand side of your Cauchy's integral formula I am taking. So left hand side we know it, so right hand side only I am picking, that is 2 pi I of f of a. Here for I1 the value of a is 1, so therefore for I1 value of a is out here 1. So therefore 2 pi I of f of 1. So this value of f of 1 you apply in f of z. Our f of z is out here sine pi z square plus cos pi z square. There you replace the value of z as 1. So sine pi 1 square plus cos pi 1 square. So 2 pi I into sine pi 1 square will be 1. 1 into sine pi is sine pi. Similarly cos pi. So you check, we know 2 pi I sine pi is 0 plus cos pi is minus 1. So therefore plus into minus 1 is nothing but minus 1. That minus and 2 pi I is nothing but minus 2 pi. So we got the answer of I1 as minus 2 pi I. Similarly, I will go directly for I3 first, because we'll apply for I3 also, we'll apply what here? Cauchy's integral formula. So it is nothing but 2 pi I of f of a. So in I3 the value of a is 2, so replace z as what here? 2. So sine pi 2 square plus cos pi 2 square, so 2 square is 4, 2 square is 4, so it will become sine pi 4 pi and cos pi 4 pi. So but sine pi sine of 4 pi is 0 and cos of 4 pi is 1, so answer is 2 pi. So now we'll take I2. For I2 we'll need to apply generalized Cauchy's formula, which is given by integration of f of z minus a raised to n plus 1 dz, 2 pi I upon n pi, n factorial, f of n of a, this n is nothing but integrate. So here in I2, we know that a value is 1 and n value is 1, because it is z minus 1 square, that square can be written as 1 plus 1, that's why n value is 1. So right hand side of your generalized Cauchy's formula is how much, what here? It is 2 pi I upon 1 factorial f dash of 1. But what is f dash? So we know that our f of z is nothing but sine pi z square plus cos pi z square. You have to differentiate this, we'll get. So differentiation of cos pi z square is sine pi z square is cos pi z square into differentiation of this. Differentiation of pi z square is what here? Pi times 2z, which can I have written as 2 pi z. Similarly, differentiation of cos pi z square is minus times sine pi z square into differentiation of pi z square is 2 pi z. So rearrange it. So it is into here. Okay, be careful, this is into, so therefore this is not angle, this is into, because we are differentiating, this means it will be into, that's why I kept in bracket. So this 2 pi z and 2 pi z will keep outside. What left here? Cos pi z square minus sine pi z square. So when z is 1, that is by using this value, when a is 1 or z is 1, so when z is 1, so it happens, what happens here? 2 pi into 1, cos of 1 square is what here? 1, so that's cos pi. Sine pi of 1 square is 1, so that's why it is sine pi. So cos pi is minus 1 and sine pi is 0, so on simplification minus 2 pi will get it. So f dash of 1, but this f dash of 1 you need to apply here. So I2 will become 2 pi I upon 1 factorial, which is 1. F dash of 1 you replace as what here? Minus 2 pi. So minus 2 pi into 2 pi I will become what here? Minus 4 pi, 4 I pi square. Now we got the values of I1, I2, I3. So apply the right hand side of equation 1 as minus times I1 answer, you write it. I2 answer, you write it. I3 answer, you write it. So simplify, you will get what here? 4 pi I into 1 plus pi. This is for first option. Similarly, for second curve, that is, this is the first curve. Second curve, they have given second curve of radius 1 by 2. So we know that, so I1, in I1, the value of z, which is nothing but a, is 1. And second integral, I2, a value is 1. And third integral, a value is 2. We know that 1 by 2, which is less than this 1 by this all three value. So therefore, there 1, 1, 2, all these three points are greater than the radius of this circle. So therefore, if it is greater, we need to apply Cauchy's formula, Cauchy's theorem. If it is greater, Cauchy's theorem. If it is on the circle and inside the circle, we need to apply Cauchy's integral formula or generalize in Cauchy's integral formula. Remember this point. So it is outside the circle, these points are. So therefore, we need to apply Cauchy's integral formula directly, and we have to say that I1 0, I2 0, I3 0. So therefore, final result is also 0 here. Next one, circle number 3. So mod z is equal to 3 by 2. Remember, 3 by 2 is nothing but 1.5. So we know that the values of a in first integral is a, 1, value of a in second integral is 1, and value of a in third integral is how much here? 2. So we know that 1, 1 inside this circle, but 2 is outside. So therefore, so we can find the result of I1 and I2, but I3 is what here? 0 directly, because the point a is equal to 2 is outside this radius 3/2 or 1.5. So the I3 answer is directly 0. Only we need to find the value of I1 and I2. So therefore, what we can say here? Therefore, the point 1, this is 1, lies inside the circle 3/2, not all 3. So I1 and I3. So for I1 apply Cauchy's integral formula, and for I2 apply generalized Cauchy's integral formula. So I1 is 2 pi I f of 1. So f of 1 is nothing but 1. Already we have simplified f of 1. You just check in the previous step. So we'll get 2 pi I. But I3 is 0. I'm writing directly because, but it is because what here? Which is outside the circle, mod z is equal to 3/2. And for I2, 2 pi I upon n factor, because we need to apply the right hand side of your generalize. So f raised to n of a value is 1 here. So we know the simplification of f dash of 1 in the previous step. So which is the direct answer is minus 2 pi, apply here. So we'll get finally the answer is what here? Minus 4 pi square I. You take the value of I1, I2 and I3. Apply in the equation number 1 of right hand side. So we'll get 2 pi I plus 4 pi square I plus 0, because I3 is 0. So simplification is what here? 2 pi I into 1 plus 2 pi. So in this way, so this concept completed completely. So we have seen the examples based on Cauchy's theorem, Cauchy's integral formula and generalize Cauchy's integral formula.